Shri Bharat, and I'm from Edmonton, Canada. My guru is Srimati Vishakha Hari. Firstly, I would like to thank Srimati Shobhana Sujit Kumar, SR Fine Arts, and the committee San Jose, California, USA, for providing this wonderful opportunity to perform as a part of the Margari series. I have with me on the violin Mukund Krishnan, who is a disciple of Sri Sikkil Balasubramanyam. On Mridangam, I have with me Bhavyan Tuvuru, who is a disciple of Sri Srinivasa Arangi Rao. The Supreme Personality of Godhead is known to exist and to be an ultimate source from whom everything emanates and by whom everything is maintained in this world. This is indicated in the Vedas, Puranas, Upanishads, historical literature such as Srimad Bhagavatam, Srimad Ramayanam, Sangeeta literature and many others. Bhagavatam has defined bhakti as the flow of the mind towards the Almighty at the slightest hearing of the Lord, just like the river flows towards the ocean uninterruptedly, inevitably. We all think and understand that veneration, surrender and respect is the only ways to attain the Supreme Personality's grace and benevolence. That is, these are the only ways of bhakti. But that is not entirely true. Bhagavatam proclaims bhakti to be practiced in 9 different forms. Prahlada tells his father that a man can practice devotion in 9 forms, namely Shravanam, listening to the Lord's glory, Kirtanam, singing of the Lord's glory, Smaranam, contemplation, thinking about the Lord, Archanam, Padasevanam, worshipping the Lord, especially his feet, Vandanam, saluting, Dasyam, serving him like a servant, Sakhyam, moving with him as a friend, and Atmanivedanam, offering oneself to him. There are multiple references of these 9 forms of bhakti. In today's fast-changing world, friendship is what brings people together. Affection, trust, intimacy, faith, and esteem is what classifies a friendship. A true friend is one who has the best interest for you and would do anything to keep you safe. If we directed this friendship towards the Supreme Personality of Godhead or Bhagavan himself, then it is called Sakya Bhakti. This is the best form of relationship that consists of only unconditional love that is devoid of any discrimination that is based on religion, caste, creed, culture, tradition, race, species, rich or poor. When we befriend the Supreme Personality himself, we have nothing to worry about as we have the best possible friend we could ask for. There are multiple references to this not only in the Bhagavatam but also in Narayaniyam, Sangeeta Bhakta Manjari by Swati Tirunal, Kritis by Saint Tyagarajar and many more. In fact, the Kriti that we sang in Mohanam Dayarani, Tyagaraja says or considers himself to be the friend of Lord Rama. Today, we will be looking at Sakya Bhakti or Sakyam, the divine friendship. We'll be looking at different friends of the Lord's that he befriended through time and age. I will be using Srimad Bhagavatam, that's penned by Vedavyasa, Srimad Ramayanam, penned by Sage Valmiki, and Govinda Shatakam and Kuchelopakhyanam, that's penned by my revered guru, Sri Sri Krishna Premi Swamigar, as a reference. In Kishkindha Kandam, in Ramayanam, when Lord Rama and his brother Lakshmana were in search of Devi Sita, who was abducted by the evil King Ravana, they stumbled upon the monkey territory Kishkindha that was ruled by the monkey king Sugriva. Lord Rama extended an arm of friendship to Sugriva. Sugriva said, Tanmamai vaisha satkaro labhaschaivottama prabho. Yatvam ichasi sauhardam vanarena maya sah. These shlokas are taken from 5th chapter of Kishkindha Kandam in Valmiki's Srimad Ramayanam. Sugriva says, O Lord, I'm very honored, very happy that you, a king, wants to be friends with me, a vanara, a mere kapi, a mere monkey like me. I give my hand to establish our bond of friendship. Lord Rama was very happy to hear these words that he hugged a monkey, Sugriva. Sakhe plavangadipaha Sugriva then shared his woes with Lord Rama. Sugriva's brother Vali had usurped the kingdom. abducted Sugriva's wife and banished him to the forest. When Lord Rama heard of this, he vowed to help Sugriva and with no expectation in return, but solely for friendship. A friend in need is a friend indeed. O kavana charulana nadu sahodadavadu karanaka. O kavana charulana nadu sahodadavadu karanaka. O kavana charulana nadu sahodadavadu. Didn't you, O Rama, befriend Okavanacharu, one monkey man, and establish a bond of friendship as strong as brotherhood? Sugriva was an equally good friend too. Even though Lord Rama did not ask for any help to find Devi Sita, Sugriva vowed to help Rama to find Devi Sita, as rightly a friend should do. Sugriva said, Tvan vayasyosi me hrudayo hyekan dukkhan sukhan chanau Sugrivo raghavan vakyam iti uvacha prahrishtavat. Sugriva said, O Rama, your pleasure is my pleasure. Your happiness is my happiness. Your grief is my grief. I share your sorrow. Sugriva surrendered the entire monkey army at Rama's service for battle. He made it his sole purpose to find Devi Sita and to rescue Devi Sita that he went on to attack King Ravana when King Ravana was at his palace. He came back with King Ravana's crown after a fight with him. Rama was very startled after seeing Sugriva do this, that he told Sugriva, "Oh Sugriva, I don't want you hurt in any manner. I don't want my friend to be hurt in any manner just because you had to find Devi Sita. If that is the case, it's okay if I don't find Devi Sita, or it's okay if I don't rescue her." Such was the divine friendship between Rama, the Supreme Personality, and Sugriva, a mere monkey, of having promises, of keeping promises and having each other's back. Rama had many friends too, other friends. For example, Guhan, who was a hunter, and many more. In the interest of time, we will just be looking at a few friends of Rama and a few friends of Krishna. The Supreme Personality of Godhead, incarnated as Krishna, also befriended numerous friends. Most of little Krishna's transcendental pastimes took place in Vrindavan, which is in present-day Uttar Pradesh, India. Vrindavan is described as a luscious green forest with the perennial Yamuna river flowing up to the brim, sweet-smelling air, the cows grazing, the flowers blooming with the bees buzzing, and so on. On one such fine day, little Krishna and his friends, who were a bunch of gopas or mere cowherd boys, decided to have a picnic after a long day of grazing the cattle. They tied up the cows and the calves to the tree and sat down and settled down on the luscious green grassy ground. Like the whirl of the lotus flower that is surrounded by petals and leaves, Krishna sat in the middle with all his friends around him, so each of them could see Krishna and Krishna could see each of them. All the kids had brought different kinds of preparation from their homes. They either used the rocks, or they used the bark of the tree, or the leaves. Some used fruits, some used flowers, some used their baskets as plates for their feast. They brought number of dishes. There was coconut rice, there was tamarind rice, there was lemon rice, there was curd rice, there was vegetable rice, there was dal, there was sambar, number of Indian savories, snacks, and a lot of sweets. Each of them was sharing what they had brought from home with Krishna and amongst each other. They were all having a very good time, laughing, cracking jokes, having fun. Krishna, the Supreme Personality, sat in the middle with his flute tucked on his right hand side waist, his horn bugle and cow driving stick tucked onto his left. He had brought yogurt rice from home, so he placed his curd rice on the palm of his hand and placed different flavored pickles in between his fingers. Krishna and his friends would have a bite of the yogurt rice from his palm and bite off their favorite tasting pickle from his fingers. The Supreme Personality, who is a yajna bhoka, that is, the one who eats through the offering of a yajna, now sat with his friends, eating from their hands, from their bare hands, and vice versa. Sharing personal jokes with each of his friends. There was jubilant laughter among them. This was how the boys, who were a bunch of mere cowherd boys, who were the gopas, and Krishna had fun, as having fun is an integral part of friendship. One other day, when the kids were engrossed playing, the calves and the cows wandered off to a nearby forest. They ultimately reached an area that was overgrown with sharp dry cane. The forest fire from the nearby forest caused them to cry out in distress. The boys realized that the cattle were missing and began searching for them frantically by tracking down their hoofprints. They were anxious and feeling guilty for having lost their only source of livelihood. Finally, Krishna, Balarama and the boys found the cattle and began their journey back home. But a giant forest fire appeared from all directions, threatening to destroy all living beings. The forest fire was propelled by the wind. The forest fire was like a chariot that was propelled by the wind, with sparks spewing all over. The cattle and the boys did not know what to do. They were very scared that they ran to Krishna and Balarama for help. Krishna, Krishna, Mahavira, cattle from this massive forest fire. Krishna then said, Nimilayatam abhishtam lochanani kya bhashatam tateyati militakshesho bhagavan pitva mukhena tantrichrat yogadhisho vyomachayat yogadhisho vyomachayat. These shlokas are taken from Srimad Bhagavatam, 10th canto, chapter 19. Hearing such painful words from his friend, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Bhagavan Harihi, asked his friends to close their eyes. Nimilayatama vaishtalochanani tya bhashata. The boys agreed and immediately closed their eyes. Then Krishna The master of all mystic and yogic power swallowed the entire forest fire through his mouth. The boys had utmost trust in Krishna. If they did not have such a trust in Krishna, their friend, they wouldn't have closed their eyes in the first place, or they wouldn't have closed their eyes without having to ask any questions. Such was the divine friendship between Krishna and the cowherd boys of trust and having fun. And this was how we can see that trust and faith in a friend is also an important aspect of friendship. Krishna had friends at each stage of his life and from all walks of life. The boys and the gopis were his childhood friends. When he went to school or Gurukulam, Sudama, a poor Brahmin boy, was his friend. When he became king, Uddhava amongst the ministers was his friend. Amongst the Kshatriyas, the Pandavas and Draupadi were his friends. Another aspect and quality of a friend is to guide each other in the right path, safeguarding one's interests. Krishna's friendship with Arjuna is an explicable example of this. The fact that the two were open to each other and would tell each other anything added the dimension of communication to a great friendship. Such was the divine companionship between Krishna and Arjuna. They were literally soulmates. We will look at Krishna-Arjuna friendship for another day, another time. Another great long-lasting friendship that we should definitely look into is that of Sudama and Krishna. The Harikathamrita Lahari that's penned by my Guru Sri Sri Anna elucidates this. Who is this Sudama? Why does everyone celebrate the glorious friendship of Sudama and Krishna when Krishna had so many other friends? Avirata virachita hari charana sarasi jayugala chintara ananda. Avirata virachita hari charana. Avirata virachita hari charana sarasi jayugala chintana ananda. Vigalita bhashpada ratra vaila. Bhashpada. So who is the Sudama indeed? There was once a friend of Krishna, a Sakha of Krishna, who was Brahmano Brahmavittamaha, who was a Brahmin, who was a Brahmavittaman, who was a great scholar, very well educated. Brahmano Brahmavittamaha Indriyateshu. At the same time, he had conquered the mighty materialistic sense organs. Jitendriyaha. He was also a Prashantatma. He was a very happy soul. Prashantatma. 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 Jitendriyaha. Sudama lived with his family, Uttrakadatradi, with his wife and a number of children. But he was always, even though he had a lot of responsibilities with his family and children, he was always Chintarahitasya, without any worry. But Sudham and his family were very poor. They were paupers actually. They were in complete poverty. Despite the deep poverty that they were in, Sudama was always fulfilled, always happy. And he was a Bhagavatottamaha. Who is a Bhagavatottamaha or a Bhagavatottaman? A Bhagavata is a person who is in constant meditation of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Bhagavan. A Bhagavatottaman is a superlative to the Bhagavata. A Bhagavatottaman is a person who the Supreme Personality is constantly meditating upon. So great was Sudama. Sudama was also called Kuchela because he was very poor. He didn't have good clothes to wear. It was all torn clothes that he adorned. How was Sudama so happy, so satisfied, despite having a huge family with number of responsibilities, despite being so poor? That was because Sudama was at peace in his heart because of his divine friendship with Krishna. A devotee will always be happy no matter what, provided he is at peace in his mind. So, a devotee will always be at Saukhyam when he is at Shanti.
Oh.
One can never be happy without being at peace in his mind. And this was how Sudama was always at peace, because of his constant devotion to Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Krishna and Sudama went to the same Gurukulam or school in Avantipuram, which is present-day Ujjain. Although Krishna was Swayam Bhagavan himself, he attended school or Gurukulam to show the world the importance of a guru or a teacher. Gurukulam was like boarding school, so Sudama and Krishna used to do all activities together. They used to wake up at the same time, they used to play at the same time, they used to play together, they used to eat together, they used to go to classes together, they used to have fun together, they used to do chores together, they used to go back to sleep at the same time. The Gurukulam was run by sage Sandipani, where numerous forms of art, craft, Vedas, Upanishads, science, literature, philosophy, and many more cultural arts and activities were taught to the children. Even though Krishna did not reveal his true self or true identity as Parandhaman, Sudama always knew that Krishna was Supreme Personality of Godhead, the God himself. Finally, school ended and education was complete and everyone had to go home. But Sudama and Krishna could not leave each other. They had become best of friends through their school days. Sudama was crying. Krishna was also crying. So Krishna, I'll miss you, Krishna. I cannot leave you and go like this, Krishna. What is this, Krishna? Krishna also says, I miss you, Sudama. I'm going to really miss all the fun times and all the things that we had done together. Sudama says, I cannot leave you like this, Krishna. I don't want to go anywhere from you. My manas, my heart cannot fathom leaving you or leaving your feet or leaving the thoughts of you and us being together. Every 5 minutes, After every 5 minutes, he used to call out to Kalyani and reminisce his memories with his friend Krishna. Kalyani, on the other hand, was not ignorant. She did not get annoyed or irritated for each and every time when Sudama called out to her, because she knew the value of Krishna and she knew the value of the divine friendship between Krishna and her husband. One day, suddenly she thought, she had an idea that Sudama could go visit Krishna. But she did not know how to bring this up to Sudama. She kept going into the kitchen, coming out, kept going in, coming out. Sudama noticed this, observed this. He called out to her, Kalyani, what is the matter? Why are you so agitated? You look at something, it looks like there's something on your mind. What is it? She then says, Nanu Brahmanna Bhagavata. Nanu Brahmanna Bhagavata. Nanu Brahmanna Bhagavata. Sakha Sakshat Shri Yapati. Sakha Sakshat Shri Yapati. Sakha Sakshat Shri Yapati. Brahmanyascha Sharanyascha. Brahmanyascha Sharanyascha. She says, Nanu Brahmanne Bhagavataha Sakha Sakshat Shri Yapati. Isn't your friend, isn't your Sakha Sakshat Shri Yapati? Isn't he the husband of Devi Lakshmi himself? Isn't he Lord Narayana himself? Sudama says, of course, no doubt about it. Then she goes on to say, don't you think as a friend you should go visit him? Krishna is busy. He's the king now. He's the king of Dwaraka. As a king, he has many things to do. But you can go visit him. Sudama says, but I'm always remembering him. There's no necessity for me to go visit him, no Kalyani. She says, that is true. I know you're always remembering him and thinking about him. You can just go visit him. We don't need to ask for any money, but at least we will be blessed. Our feet will be blessed by walking all the way to Dwaraka to see him. Our eyes will be blessed when we see Krishna. Our hands will be blessed when we give something to him. Don't you think you should go visit him? Then Sudama says, what happened all of a sudden after so many years you're telling me this? You could have told me this earlier as well. She says, exactly. I did not think of this for so many years. Maybe Krishna wants to see you. And that is why he sowed this seed of you visiting him in my head, this idea that you should go visit him. As soon as he heard that probably Krishna wants to see him, Sudama agreed to leave to Dwaraka to see Krishna, his friend. He says, I cannot go empty-handed. I need to take something with me. Poverty had struck them really bad. She did not have anything in her house to give to Krishna. She knocked on 4 houses and collected 4 fistful of flat rice or aval, they say. She tied that too in a torn cloth, but tied it safely and handed it over to Sudama. Sudama immediately left. The thought of meeting Krishna after so many years filled him with extreme thrill, extreme joy. He kept on thinking throughout his journey to Dwaraka, I hope I get to meet you, Krishna. I hope I get to see you. I hope you remember me, Krishna. Even if you don't remember me, it's totally okay. I hope I get to see you at least. Please fulfill my desire to see you, Krishna. Please fulfill my will, fulfill my expectation, fulfill my will and manoratham to see you, Krishna. Please, Krishna. Maze manorata punaketa deva. केशव माधव नारायण gardens, beautiful landscape, gardens and parks and fountains. The towers were so tall that residences were all on the top floors. Everyone was very rich and they had multiple beautiful homes. People were hustling and bustling around the city, carrying out their different trades. Everybody was very happy and very rich. Dwarka was a complete, magnificent, well-planned, well-structured, well-organized and a very prosperous city.
स्फटिकमयि विद्युत् प्रतिबिम्बितपदिकया जगमण्डल
कंचुगि गणरञ्जित राजद्वारे सोपहार कृत प्रतीक्षमहि पार महाजनमहित पारिजात मंदार पाटलाशोक परिहृत परिसरे Gadyam, it describes the beauty of Dwarka. The palaces were studded with Tatra Maragata Govedaka Vaidurya Govedaka Vaidurya Maragata, all different kinds of precious gems. Not only that, Madigana Vichita Vichita Madigana Kachita Vichitra Stambha Sahasralankrita Madigana Vichitra Stambha. So there were multiple pillars that were architectured differently designed pillars with beautiful intricate architecture. It looked like Nitya Lakshmi Vilase, that the goddess of Lakshmi, the goddess of wealth, was permanently settled in Dwarka. So rich was Dwarka. Spatikamai Bitti Pradibindita Patikaya Jagamandale Sudama could see that many structures had spaticum. Spaticum is a gem where you can see your own reflection. So many structures had spaticum. Not only buildings, but there were beautiful creepers, trees with different types of flowers. Parijata mandara patala shokam. Different types of flowers and fruits. In the midst of beautiful Dwaraka was Krishna Bhavane. Sudama finally reached Krishna's palace. He was ecstatic. He had tears in his eyes. Bashpa Purita Vinochana. And he finally reached Krishna's palace. Inside the palace was a huge king's court with multiple administrators, ministers, many kings who had come to visit Krishna, traders, businessmen and so on. Everyone were having a very deep discussion. Krishna was not there, of course. Sudama went on to hear what this discussion was all about. One king says, I'm coming from Nepal, you know, I've brought so many precious stones and gems and diamonds and platinum, ruby, sapphire, topaz to gift to Krishna, but I've been waiting for the past few days. He's not given me an appointment yet. Another king says, this is nothing. I'm coming from Kerala, you know, I've brought so many cardamom, different types of spices, cashews, badam, nutmeg, cinnamon. This is nothing. I'm waiting for the past 6 months to see Krishna. Another king comes and says, what is all this? This is nothing. I'm coming all the way from Kashmir with sacks of expensive saffron to give it to Krishna. I have been waiting for 2 years for him to give me an appointment and I have not seen him yet. Do you know that? Everyone were just talking about this and Sudama was very disheartened to hear this. Sudama felt, I don't have anything with me, one four fistful of flat rice I have, that's all. I have nothing to give to Krishna. And I just arrived in Dwaraka. I don't have any appointment. I don't think Krishna will see me like this. I think I should leave Dwaraka. So Sudama decided to leave Dwaraka. He turned to leave the palace when the guards summoned him. He says, me? Are you calling me? He says, they say, yes, please come in. They summoned him to the king's personal altars. Sudama says, there must be a mistake. I don't have anything on me. I have nothing on me. I'm very poor. They say, we know. Sudama continues to say, no, but I just arrived. All those kings, they have been waiting for so long with so many expensive jewels. I don't have anything. I just came to Dwaraka. They say, yes, we know. Krishna has given us orders that we must summon poor men like you first before anything. Sudama says, is that so? I'm very embarrassed to go in. Will you go and tell Krishna that his friend Sudama from school has come? The guards agreed and they went inside the king's chambers. Krishna was resting on a huge grand sandalwood swing that was strung together with gold chains. It had a massive white velvet bedding with Devi Rukmini on the side fanning him with a grand hand fan. Krishna's curly jet black hair was moving in the wind that was caused by the fan. His yellow robes or pitambaram were shining across the hall and that was also slightly battering in the wind that was created by the fan. Krishna's blue skin tone was looking magnificent with his blue skin tone with his Vaijanti mala on the side as he laid down. His fingers had multiple beautiful finger rings with multiple gems and his other hand was stretched across his knee and his divine feet one on top of the other. It really looked like Vaikuntham itself. The guards then said, there's a person to visit you. There was no response from Krishna. They said, the person who has come to visit you is a poor, very poor person. Krishna says, okay, go on. The guards then relaxed. His name is Sudama, he says. He says he's your classmate and friend. As soon as Krishna heard Sudama, Krishna jumped out of the swing and ran towards the door, screaming, Sudama, Sudama, you finally came to see me, Sudama. I was waiting for you, Sudama. I have missed you, Sudama. Krishna ran towards the door. Sudama also on the other side came running, hearing Krishna's screams. Krishna, you remember me, Krishna? You remember me? We used to go to school together. Sakya priyasya viprashe. Krishna hugged Sudama. Krishna did not discriminate Sudama from his dirty body or poor self from travel. Krishna just hugged him. Ananta Krishna Anubhava Ananta Krishna on one side, Parandhaman on one side, Sudama on one side. Kuchelan on one side, Suchelan on one side. It was truly a momentous meet. So dharam paradham majam Suchelam kuchelam sudharam paradham majam Suchelam kuchelam sudharam paradham majam Suchelam kuchelam sudharam Param Ramu. Thank you. stories, Krishna himself washed Sudama's feet, massaged his feet that were dirty from travel, cleaned him, clothed him, gave him new robes to wear, prepared a lavish feast for him to eat, gave him water to drink. Krishna fed Sudama one bite, Sudama fed Krishna one bite. Krishna then said and asked, Sudama, did you get anything for me? Sudama was very embarrassed to give him the fistful of flat rice that he began to shy away. But Krishna was very smart. He spotted the four fistfuls of flat rice sack and snatched it from Sudama. He opened it with so much enthusiasm and happiness that he began eating it and shared some with Devi Rukmini as well. Sudama was feeling very happy from the sweet gesture that Krishna had shown. Finally, it was time to leave. Sudama did not want to leave, did not have the heart to leave Krishna again. He was sad, at the same time very happy that he got to meet Krishna. Finally, Sudama decided to leave, and as soon as Sudama reached his house, he couldn't find his house anymore. Instead, there stood a palace just like that of Krishna's in its place. His wife came out running in beautiful robes that were just like Devi Rukmini's. His children were eating great, grand food. Sudama knew that it was completely Krishna's grace and benevolence. He could not bear Krishna's kripai. He was overwhelmed. He kept thinking, just because I gave you four fistful of flat rice, you gave me a four-story building with all amenities in its place. This shows us how the Lord would take a thousand steps for us, even if we took just a few towards Him. Such was the divine, long-lasting friendship of Sudama and Krishna. When the Lord can befriend a monkey, a hunter, a poor Brahmin man, cowherd boys, or anyone, why can't we, swimming in this world of material displeasure and sorrow? We can and must take steps towards the ultimate preceptor. All these divine friendships show us that the Supreme Almighty does not discriminate any devotee based on anything. They also show us that any one of us can perform devotion at the Lord's feet to attain materialistic and spiritual wealth and wisdom. With that, I would like to conclude this program. I would again like to thank Shobhana Sujit Kumar ji and the committee of SR Finance, Fine Arts San Jose, USA. I would like to thank my accompanists Mukund Krishnan and Bhavendu Guru. I would like to thank all my friends and family for supporting me in this. We will conclude with the Mangalam.
Thank you. Namaskaram.